Welcome back to ModelTTips-Hyphen.com. I'd like to introduce you to my friend, or at least at this point in time we are. We don't know about the rest of the day. But Mr. Nick Nicholas out of West Pueblo, Colorado. Nick's an old-time Model T guy, been around the hobby for about 40-some-odd years. Had a real active club here in Colorado at one point in time, and they rebuilt a lot of different things over here in this shop. So right now he's going to share with us how to redo a Model T starter. And one of the things that I learned on about Model T starters is you don't have one on a Montana 500 car.
No, you don't. Weight. No, you don't. You push.
Nick also has been involved in the Model T the Montana 500 races over the years and has won it several times. So obviously he knows his way around an old T model. So with that said, show us how this is done.
Okay, here we go. Now, there's good information in the Model T Ford Service Book, in the Model T Ford Club of America Electrical Systems Book. If you'll follow these books, you ought to be able to overhaul a generator or a starter. Here we got a good Model T starter, a good core. I already took it apart yesterday and cleaned it all up and put it back together just so we wouldn't have to show me hanging over a filthy parts washer. We're gonna take it apart, go through all the parts, figure out what's wrong with it, and then what to do to cure that problem. And what we're gonna do is we're probably gonna do a complete overhaul. You can completely overhaul one for about $140, including the fields. If you buy one that's done, it's gonna cost you about $380. So you can save some money. And we'll start now by starting to tear it down. Sitting in front of me is parts that we're going to need to rebuild this starter. Here is a rear bushing. The bushing that's in the back of it now is Babbitt, and we will take it out and install this bushing. Then we've got the center bushing, which is this with a seal. The one that's in it now is all one piece, but it doesn't have a seal. This is one that the vendors are selling. That's in two piece, and we can put a seal in. If we put a seal in, that'll stop one of the oil leaks in the Model T. Just one of them. Here's a set of brushes that a lot of times you don't need to put a new set of brushes in because the old brushes don't get much wear because the starter motor don't get used very much. Here's a terminal bolt that we're gonna put on the fields. We're going to take you through this step by step, but to do a starter, a lot of times you have to have some special tools. You need a lathe and some other special tools that I will show you as we go. Okay, we're going to start by taking the band off. Taking the brushes out. I notice when I take these brushes out, that they're Ford Script brushes. So they're probably the brushes that come in it. We'll compare them to the length of a new brush. Then we can decide whether we want to use a new brush or not. Now we're going to take an ohmmeter and we're going to test to make sure that the insulated brush is insulated. No continuity, so that one's good, and this one's good. The ones on the other side are grounded. So I think we're good on the insulators on the brushes. I don't think we'll need to change those. Now, if it was a problem, if one of these was grounded, we'd have to drill out these four rivets, take the brush bracket out, drill out the rivets that hold the brush holder down, put a new insulator in, put new rivets in, and then re-rivet back in to the head of the starter. It's quite a chore. Generally, those are not bad. They seem to hold up good. This armature fits very tight in this old bearing, and I think it's probably because it's dry. So we'll just use a Babbitt hammer and bump it out of there. Now we've got the armature out. This armature has to be checked on a growler to see if it's good. Or you can use an ohmmeter and just hold the ohmmeter on the fields or on the commutator and on the outside and make sure there's no ground there. Okay. This is a growler. That's the way you check the armature. We're going to show it on both videos because it checks either the starter or the generator armature or any wound armature. This is the way it has to be checked. The armature in the starter and the generator are checked in the same manner. We've got a good one here. And then it also has an ohmmeter where you can test just across this way to see if it's shorted or not. You have to have it on and it makes a lot of noise. We'll try right now with the ohmmeter. If the light comes on, that means you've got a short. This is not a good armature. Now we'll take the front off the starter by removing the screws. Now that we've got it apart, one of the things that's very important that we have to check is this Babbitt bushing right here. It needs to be 1 inch in diameter, about 1 inch and 1/1000ths, 1.5/1000ths. That's where your starter drive goes in. All your other bearings line up off of that point. That's the way you get all three bearings to line up. now we're going to push this bearing out. Okay, Mike, we want to melt this Babbitt out. Okay. We want to tin it and re-pour it with that little mold I made.
Okay. We'll get that done. Okay, so I'm putting the nose into the Babbitt, yep, using the Babbitt pot to melt out the inner stuff.
It's probably done about now because it's pretty thin. And then I'll take a little soldering salts as long as it's clean enough in there and tinned up.
Yep.
Okay. There's some rust. It didn't take a tin very good, so I'll clean out. Clean it off the best I can, and I'm going to take it over to the bead blast cabinet, and I'm going to blast that out so I can get a good coat of tin on it. You can see what it did there. It just didn't.
It didn't tin good.
Didn't, yeah, tin good, so.
Looks good. You got to get that surface to tin before the Babbitt will stick to it.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, you got a good job.
Got a good job on it. Use a little plug mold, Nick made. Just kind of eyeball center it up. He's going to bore out all of it. I'm going to get me a ladle full of some Babbitt here and pour it in there.
The ladle.
Look good to you?
Yep, looks good.
Alright. So we'll let that cool down. And when Nick gets ready to do the machining, we'll lock that plug out and he can bore out that bearing.
The next step is to take the field coil out of the housing. And we do that by taking out the screws on the sides and sliding it out. We'll show you how to do that in just a second. But first, let me show you, I've taken some mold starters apart and some of the things you find on the fields. The fields is one of the biggest reasons that a starter goes bad. A starter is a high torque, high horsepower motor and it has a heavy set of fields in it. You can see this guy decided he'd just wire his back together. I don't know, evidently it didn't work. This one, somebody went in and re-insulated the ends and tried to spray some insulation, but as you can see, it didn't work. So that shorted out and the starter wouldn't work. Just some of the things you find out when you tear starters apart. Okay, we're gonna start removing the fields out of the starter. They're held in by big screws in the side, quarter inch. Or 5/16, I guess. They're staked in, so they're hard to get out. If you have a large impact screwdriver, that'll break them loose. I don't have that, so I use this. It's an old half-inch ratchet with a screwdriver attachment on it. And this is the way I do it, and this is kind of the way they do it in the book. All you have to do is loosen them up. If you can get them to turn a quarter of a turn, you're in good shape. Okay, now that we've got them loose, we can run them out with a big screwdriver. At this point, we can test the fields to see if they're grounded. Put our old meter up. And they're showing a ground. They're showing a ground. So they're probably not good. Okay, now we can finish running them out. The choo-choo train that takes me away from you. Now we've got the fields out of the body. Now that we've determined that this field has a short, we know that we've got to replace it with a new field. The new field, we're going to change to this type. And in order to get ready to assemble, we've got to check our armature. We've got to turn our commentator, undercut the commentator, undercut the micas, and then we're going to check and see if it's straight. We're going to put it between centers and check if it's straight. Then we've got a bearing in here, an old Babbitt bearing. Starter. So what we're going to do is we're going to drill a hole 9/16, because that's the size for a 5/8 fine thread tap. Then we're going to run a tap in it and thread that. Then we got a puller that we're going to try to pull that bearing out with. Let me take this over to the vise and see if we can get it to pull out. John Steele stopped by this morning from Montana and left us with this nice race car picture from my garage. Now we're going to try to remove this. Wow, that all come out pretty good. We're going to put a new ball bearing instead of the brass bushing. And here's the ball bearing. And then here's the extra sleeve to make up for this piece right here. We're going to put that in now. And it seems to fit pretty snug. Put the armature between centers on the lathe, and we're going to turn them and find out the high spot. See if this shaft is bent. We can see it's about 10 thousandths out. Mark the high spot. Now we're going to go over here and use the sledgehammer mechanic method and try to straighten it a little bit. Just take and lay it on the anvil and take a Babbitt hammer and kind of give it a little smack. Right there, it looks like we got about half of it out of there. We'll try it again. Now we're going to take a light cut off the commentator just to make sure it's running true under the brushes. I bet I never took off 10 thousandths. We got a nice true surface for the brushes to rub against. Now we're going to take over to the vise and undercut the micas. I'm going to let Mike undercut the micas. And while he's doing that, I'm going to set the jig up in the lathe to bore the nose out of the nose Chicago, bearing. Chicago, I'll show you around. I love it to bet your bottom dollar you lose the blues in Chicago. Mike Bender poured the bearing in the front of this a while ago. So now I've built a jig to go in the four-jaw chuck. We indicated this internal circle to make sure it's running true. It will set up on this machine surface on the front of the starter cover. We're going to set up on that, bolt this to that, and then bore this hole. Everything is in relation to this bearing. We're gonna bore this hole out, and it wants to be about 1 inch, 1.5 thousandths to allow for the starter drive. They could not shut down all State Street, that great street. I just wanna say, they do things they don't do on
from Broadway say they have the time of their life. I saw a man, he danced with his wife in Chicago, Chicago, my hometown. Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, I'll show you around. I love it. I bet your bottom dollar you'll lose the blues in Chicago. Chicago, the town that Billy Sunday could not shut down. On State Street, that great.
We're going to push this bushing in the front nose of the starter, and we're going to push it deep enough for this seal to go in there. Now we got this bushing pushed in far enough for this seal to go in. We won't install the seal at this point in time because now we have to line ream this bushing from this surface. Now we're set up and we're getting ready to ream the bushing that we just put in the nose of the starter. That bushing is not a good size. That bushing is 675 thousandths. 675 thousandths is not a dimension. I don't know where that come from. So what we got to do, what you have to do in order to do that, is you have to use an adjustable reamer. This adjustable reamer is a 21 to 23 thousandths. It's this front bushing where the starter drive goes in. And in order to do that, I had to build a bushing that'll fit inside. So our reamer aligner will go inside of that and fit. Now we can take our reamer and run through here and cut the bushing to size off of this bushing. Okay, we're going to ream this out. We got to adjust our reamer a little bit. You'll have to adjust your reamer. Start small and adjust your reamer until you've got it to where it fits just right. You just want a nice little fit. You can tell that ever so nice. When we install the field coil in the starter, you turn it so where the terminal bolt is going to line up with the notch in the starter housing. Now we're installing the cleats that hold the starter windings in. We're going to run them down with the screwdriver just to hold them in place until we can tighten them down for permanent use. Now we're going to lock in the screws that hold those cleats in tight. Now we're going to install the terminal stud, and by doing that, it slides over the copper winding. We drill a hole through it, put a pin before we rivet it down, and then we're going to solder that for a good connection. Here we're drilling with a 3/16 drill, and now we're going to rivet over. Mike's going to help me here. Right here, we're just riveting that little pin to make sure we've got a good connection. Now we're putting a little solder paste on there. We're going to solder it so we can get that good connection. Now we're going to take a large soldering iron and try to get it against here and solder this without melting the solder joints on the other sides of it.
Do it over again.
We're using a big soldering copper here to try to get enough heat so we can melt that in. It looks like it's working. We used these vise grips kind of as a heat sink to make sure that we didn't melt the solder. Now we cleaned it up a little bit, and now we're going to bend the starter terminal to where it fits into the notch. You put their insulating bushing in first before you turn it over, because there's not room to put it in afterwards. After we got that copper hot, it's annealed pretty good, now it's pretty soft. The copper's annealed pretty good, so it's bending pretty good. You got to reshape the ends there a little bit so you can make it fit, but it all goes pretty good. Trying to move that terminal around a little bit to where that insulator fits good. It all moves around pretty good. There, now we're happy with that. We're about ready to assemble the starter. But first, we've got to assemble the starter and check our in play to see if we've got too much in play. We took the base of the starter, we took the old bearing out, the old Babbitt bearing, and we replaced it with the ball bearing. We pushed the sleeve on the armature for the space, to get our space right for our brushes. We push the new bearing in the front of the, for the front bearing on the starter. We've reamed it to fit. We still have got to put in the seal. We're not going to do that till after we do, till just before we make final assembly. We put the field windings in. We got the terminal stud finally put the way it goes, and now we're going to put it together. First thing, we're just going to put this together. We're not going to put any brushes in. We're just going to put it together to check our in play on our starter. We'll just put in a couple of screws because we're going to have to take it apart again. At this point, we're just assembling it enough till we can check our in play. So now we set it up so we can check the in play with the dial indicator. Set the starter in the vise and made some spacers here so we can get it. We looks like we got about 45 thousandths. So now we're going to have to cut a spacer to go in there to take that 45 thousandths up. Here's a spacer, a little bushing that we made out of an old brass bushing. Put it in the lathe and used a parting tool and cut it off, about 40 thousandths. I think it's going to take up the slack. We're going to put it on the shaft. We got our end plate taken care of. So now we're going to take it apart. We got to put our seal in, and then we're ready for final assembly. There's a proper way to put the seal in. We're wanting to stop the oil flow going that way, so we want to put it in that way. We'll take an old bushing and kind of seat it. Okay, now we'll start to reassemble. With the terminal on top, we want the clearance on this side. Watch for the mail. I'll never fail. If you don't get a letter, then you know I'm in jail. Okay, now that we got the end cap settled, tied on, now we'll go ahead and finish putting the starter together and put the brushes in. We'll put these two screws in we didn't put in a while ago. Remember to make sure you use the lock washers or these things will come apart. The starter of your car just won't start, but if you do it with the generator, it'll tear up the timing gear. Believe me. We're getting ready to install the brushes, but now you might compare your brushes. The ones that I took out are Ford Script brushes. Look at the difference in length between that and a new brush. Starters don't get used much. The brushes are generally not bad. So if you want to save $15, there's one place you can do it. I'm going to tighten the starter terminal. This is something, you don't want to over-tighten this. That's a lot of the problems with starters, is that's been over-tightened and that rivet's broken loose. And on a factory one, that rivet is the only thing that's holding it on. It's not soldered. Now we'll install the brushes. I like to use my screwdriver that holds the screw. It makes it nice to put those together. And I try to put the brush terminal on top of the starter terminal, because if anything needs changed, it's going to be the brush. Now we got the brushes installed. Now it's time to see if we got it working right. Now we're going to use a battery charger to see if it works. Looks like to me we got a good finished product. We're going to check and see how the starter drive fits. If that's all in alignment, all those bearings are in alignment, this will fit good. Went good. So we did good. I think the biggest reason that most of these shafts are bent is because they were stored with the drive off of them. That's sticking out, it gets dropped, that's bent. If you're not going to use it, if you're going to put it on the shelf, put a starter drive on it. I think that'll save that from getting bent again. We got a good complete starter. Saved ourselves a few bucks by doing it ourselves. I want to thank you for watching. Remember, there's a lot of ways of doing this. Everybody's got their own way. This is the way I do it, and it seems to work pretty good.
I'll never fail.
You don't get a letter, then you'll know I'm in jail.
Tipsy, no problem.